Back to my RP1 playthrough on hard difficulty, where in the last episode, we made orbit. Rather than my flying the orbit again, I force completed a contract because I was 6 kilometers off. And in this episode, we will go for first scientific satellite. So here we go. So we have... Oh yes, and we have an X-Planes High flight to do. I guess I'll do that so we can... I don't know what order I want to do those things in. I guess maybe this. So, let's see. Oh yes, that's right. I'm going to change the location to LC-16. Wait. I'm confused. Where is this supposed to be? Not LC-16. Yeah, it is LC-26. I was right the first time. Just double check that this is the right thing. Sure looks right to me, as stupid monstrosities go. Make sure that we can still get to orbit. Probably something like that. What the heck launch complex this is, because it's not not LC-26. Maybe it is, but it doesn't look like it. It's not the one I was used to from before, that's for sure. So, stop at stage. That looks correct. Oh yuck, I have to fix that. I forgot about that. Alright, so I had not pitched down enough, clearly. We're in space. Okay. Okay, and we'll go at 1 minute. Okay. So that's fine. All right. 50-30-50. Seems fine. Oh yeah, I was gonna check. 1 thing here. Yeah, okay, I did already deal with that. That's cool. And that's cool. Okay. Right. Let's fly the airplane. And accept the contract. So that's gonna be a little dicey, but it'll be okay. Okay, that's bright sunlight. Wait, what? Oh, is this another one of those? Is somebody currently training? Yes. Dale is currently training. Okay. Guess we gotta wait a couple days. At least it's June, so it's nice bright weather. Hey, Squirrel. Yes, making configs is hard. I hope you saw I haven't released Arrow Kerbalism yet, but I did close your Vostok issue by assigning resources. You can actually look what I did there if you want a model of how that's done, because I just checked in the committed the Vostok stuff there fairly recently. Cool. Glad it's helpful. All right. Let's see if this was enough. No. One more day. So we missed 3 extra days worth of rewards for that contract. Oh well. Nice bright sunlight. Let's try this one more time. Dale Franklin is going up to 75 kilometers. What is this? You're actually going to test your changes? That's amazing. I wish more people would do that. Sometimes including me, but I try to at least have some. hot fixes notwithstanding. Gonna miss this plane, but don't worry, I will invest at least as much time making the next plane. Although, actually, I plan to put a J-57 on this. So we'll still be flying this for jet contracts. Go for a climb, and I'm going to try to stay at about 45 degrees this time. Not higher than that. Because we need to be above 600 meters per second. All the time we're up in the high, so. Might need to adjust the AOA limits. Yeah, I think I actually did this wrong. I didn't get a fast enough run first. Yeah, I have to do it again. Shoot. Yes, basically, I should have done exactly the same thing I did last flight, which was run up to about, oh, oops. That's way higher dynamic pressure than I was planning on. Run up to about 600 meters per second, and then go for a zoom climb of about 60 degrees. But I was hoping that I could do a less aggressive climb and spend more time above 40 kilometers and above Mach 2. But wait, what? Okay, something very fishy is going on. I used up all my delta V. What just happened? I guess I was not paying attention and didn't have enough climb, so we just spent it all on drag losses. Squirrel, you probably do need to sum up. So, when you sum up the life support supplies as well, like, it will probably amount to a considerable amount. I'm also unsure whether the masses given for things are with or without consumables. Certainly for Apollo, we know those numbers. I'm not sure if we know those numbers for Soyuz. I mean, we know those numbers for like modern Soyuz probably, but I don't know if we know those numbers for old ones. But like they do add up fast. So when I added the Vostok life support resources, it was like 150 kilograms, which, or even more, which is an appreciable amount. It's like 5% of the reentry module's mass. Okay, my guess is that the potassium superoxide at 47 liters of it is only going to be, probably going to be somewhere, but I don't remember the density offhand, but it's probably fairly close to the density of water, which is to say about 47 kilograms. And just in case, let me check my CD and make sure it's correct. I guess that's correct. Yeah, 3 degrees angle of attack, that's probably correct. We got a bunch of wing, so 3 degrees alpha makes a big difference. Get a little faster before we make our run. Okay. All right, this is looking much better. Okay. Wait. How is it unmet requirements? Oh, 650, not 600. Okay, sure. Whatever. Now it's running. Okay. Did I screw this up again? I think I screwed this up again. Yeah. No, maybe not. No, we're gonna be okay. Just barely, but we're gonna be okay. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. I pitched down at the wrong moment. All right, you know what? I'm going to solve this problem because I do not want to do this a fifth time. Wait, what? Oh, because we're already going down, that's why. Okay, that'll do. So now, come on. Want to stay above 40 kilometers as long as possible. We're going to duck under 40. Oh, yes, that's much better. And now we need to stay above 650 as long as possible. Milking it for all worth. And that's as good as it gets. And hey, look, it's the cape down there. And this time we can actually see it. That kind of matters a lot. All right, let's make ourselves draggy. Oh yeah, and let's fix the control surfaces too. Okay. Yeah, so our pilots must be nearing their retirement dates. So I gotta check once we're back. Here we come. NorCal Planner, you're right. It does remind me of playing European Air War back like 20 years ago. We are, and yet actually, so one of the QA testers for European Air War is actually on the RR Discord. We compare. Told me some fun stories about landing an aircraft upside down, and because apparently TK had coded something in there where it like didn't actually care about the orientation, it just cared about the descent rate or something. It's pretty funny. All right, so one notch less of flaps. Here we come. Oh man, I love Telcats Over the Pacific. That and its expansion, Hellcats Over Leyte Gulf. I played the heck out of that. Yeah, I had a Gravis Mouse Stick 2, which was basically because the Macintosh did not do joysticks. It was as you probably you NorCal, you may have had one of these as well. It's like it positioned the mouse cursor on the screen based on where the joystick was. Which was sort of hilarious. So I've been flying as you saw, I flew that with mouse aim flight, but also aircraft atmospheric autopilot to damp down some of the PID wander. I do have a HOTUS, it's just in a box, and I haven't set it up. Like normally I would fly with a HOTUS, but the last flying KSP recently, it's just like it hasn't been enough, hasn't been worth it to set it up. That's going to recover. We finally got one more upgrade. That's awesome. And we got some money. So we're sitting on a nice chunk of change. What's our, let's see. So we might be able to do this, but it would need a considerable rocket and 3 kilometers per second entry pretty fast. We just did that. This one has now built up a good head of steam in terms of its rewards. I'm like vaguely tempted to see whether we can do this as well. But my hunch is that we had a bunch of Delta V, but we didn't have enough Delta V. I think we do have enough Delta V. I just ran the numbers on that. I think we do have enough Delta V to try that. What we might not have is we might not have a ground station. That is what we might not have. But let's see.
The heck?
Why did it forget all my settings? So, utterly ignoring range limits. Launching right over the VAB. The actual VAB, the Launch Complex 39 VAB. At least we're dropping the boosters over the water. Like, barely, but yes. Okay, so that apogee is lower, that's fine. Heading is 0, pitch minus 2. Will we have signal from Wallops at Apogee? Hopefully. Oh, no, our Apogee is actually high enough and close enough that we'll still have signal from the Cape. And yes, we'll have signal from Wallops as well. Okay, so this is feeling possible. Here we go. In this case, I think I want to do a minute 10, because I'm at minus 2 degrees. So, not minus 1 degree. Here we go. Nailed it. Feel good about this one. Okay, so yes, polar is possible. Polar is indeed possible. 300 by 2.3. Okay, so yeah, so that satellite is going to fulfill both for scientific satellite and polar satellite. But I want to check one thing about my flight science. So this gives me Mach 2 flight. This gives me high altitude hypersonic. Okay, so I've just checked here and was talking about high altitude flight, but high altitude flight I had thought was based on its presence in this node that it was going to be related to early stuff and there'd be more over here, but I'm wrong. Like, these are actually both the X15 science things. So yeah, it's fine that I'm not getting that much science from a single 75 kilometer flight if this is for going up to like 100 kilometers. Thank you. Okay. So, it's time to save and then make our play for this as well. And what's the rewards on this? The rewards on this are 160K. 160K is enough to unlock some good engines, barely. Which means I need to not actually spend all this money. But I can spend a good chunk of it. Let's do it. Okay, so that will leave enough money in the bank to rush things and maybe even do some unlocks. Okay. So that completes in 58 days, and this completes in 50 days. Cool. So we're going to fly some supersonic X-plane flights while we wait for good orbital engines. As well go. Okay, our delta V is 10,115. If we put one of you in here, it costs us 10 meters per second. Seems worthwhile. Costs us a good few days to change it, though, which is a shame. Unless there's anything else we can do to lower its cost, I'm not aware of anything we can do. So we'll accept the fact that it will cost a few more days. Oh, right. I don't actually have. Well, yes. Let me edit this. And. Okay, so the Skystreak B has made its last flight. As soon as we get a J57, we'll unlock that, kit it out, put some intakes on it. Off we'll go. Okay, so. It is August 13th. If we rush build the next one, we'll be okay. Takes 2 days to roll out. It's dawn. Let's not be under cloud shadows. I want to actually be able to see things. It's like 7 a.m., looks like. All right, that's. That is acceptable. All right, so let us launch our happy little probe. Here we go. Okay, this is correct. For some reason, when we were just simming things, we were on the wrong pad, but now we're on the right pad. These settings look correct from last time. Engage. Here we go. Oh, that's interesting. I'm going to try that again. Yeah, given my screw-ups earlier, I'm going to be a little bit revert happy with this flight. But I hope to. Basically, once I get out of this hole, stop the reverting. Up we go. Welcome back. You're just in time for, hopefully, the first scientific satellite to be launched. Okay, we're at least now out over the water. Although, once we extend our ground track out far enough, the booster will probably come down in, like, New York State. And yes, I'm aware this is the ugliest monstrosity that I will ever fly this campaign. Right down to having to not boat-tail the engine to save another 30 to 40 meters per second of delta V, if not more. The boosters I could boat-tail. All right, we have a good core burnout. Separation. Heading is 0 degrees. Pitch is -2. Execute. RCS to on. Save. There's the booster not very far behind us. Yeah, this is very, very Juno inspired. It's liquid Juno, right down to having a separating aft unit. Okay, here we go. Rip. I actually want to see what orbit this gets into. Although probably the others will fail as well. Be because they'll have to burn for half again their rated time. Uh-oh. So that's going to be like 90% steering losses. If only I'd remembered to cant those things outward so they'd fire through the center of mass. So we came up a kilometer and a half short. So okay. All right, with only a modicum of saves coming, we did the thing. Modicum, whatever. Okay, so we got polar. Now we have to last in orbit a day and transmit science. Okay, I'm going to turn that off until we're... Because I think the requirements are... Yes, you have to complete the rest of it and then transmit science, unless it's an ore, or unless they're... I'm not going to risk it. We're going to warp for a day. Means that I lost my I lost a day of build time, but that's fine. Okay, so we got an altitude record. Let's transmit some science. I wish you could tell it to transmit only when you're over a DSN. Uplink. Okay, well that's not making that huge a difference. What does it take to transmit science? Like, we've transmitted a kilobyte of data. Is this going to be another one of those things where it's like semi-bugged because of the data rate or something? Transmit cosmic ray science. Okay, that's weird. Like, we transmitted a bunch of data. Did it not, like, is it a weird Kerbalism thing? All right, I'm just gonna give myself enough electricity to finish that transmission. And maybe the transmission actually has to finish. We'll see how this works. Okay, there we go. Yeah, so I guess the answer is you should be transmitting the whole time. Because otherwise you run into this situation. Cool, now I know. Okay. Bye-bye. You're out of juice. You will go away now. Okay. Okay. So, we sure as heck cannot do the lunar contracts. I can technically do this. Except that I can't because I need the next level of avionics to have a lower power draw. So I can't do that yet. I guess I can do this. Has to go 3,000 kilometers per second. Meters per second. 3 kilometers per second. 200 units of sounding payload. So let's load up Wasp Bio. Build that. Oh, right. The Delta V is lying. Because Mechjeb, quite understandably, judges it based on the root part. So that is not our actual Delta V. Like, at all. Yeah, 3770. Oh, I wonder if it's not a root part problem. I wonder if it, I think it's actually not a root part problem. Yeah, it's not a root part problem. It's a staging order problem. All right, so we'll do that, and then we will fuel these tanks more. Man, that's going to take 77 days to build. I guess the bio sample is expensive. Yeah, I wonder why we're launching from this. Oh, no, it's just the last used pad, I guess. This is fine. Oh yeah, right. We start without any avionics because we're heavy. Let's see if we reach 3 km/s. Okay, yeah, we'll make it. Probably. Oh no, that delta V is wrong. So, no. Probably not. It's not wrong by that much, so we might be okay. Probably hit it on the way down. Oh, yeah, no, we were fine. Don't need to hit it on the way down. Okay, let's see what happens. This is going to be a fairly hot re-entry. Maybe should have launched more horizontal. So, ACT, that nose is full of sounding rocket payload. And crucially, it's tooled already. Okay, so we survived. We'll be fine. The other pieces of the rocket will not be fine. But we're fine. So basically, there's 2 reasons for this. One is that we needed to carry a bunch of. So I initially built this for the downrange development contracts, where you have to chuck like 600 plus units of payload. So this was rated for nine, a ton of it, and was nose cone shaped. Because like the original version of this didn't have any of this, it just had the guidance unit and this. This version with the bio capsule, these are stringers, so they're cheap. It's not actually fairings. If they were decoupling fairings, they'd be expensive, and I'd have to tool them. So, I already have 1.8 meters tooled for this, so this tooling was cheap because it was only a stage stretch or shrink. So that is why this is this weird setup. But yeah, we started this building. It will take a while to build. That's fine. It'll give us enough time to research the next thing, and then we can start building our plane. We're going to have to annoyingly carry this money around for a while, because I don't, based on changes, I don't trust the using the lunar advances to pay for unlocking good kit, so I think we need to pay for it with this and actually fly some missions with it first before I feel comfortable going to lunar. So that's done in 33 days. This gives us this gives us supersonic intakes and the J-57. All right. Save the game. Take the contract. Can't do that until we get X-15 parts, which will not be for a while. Lunar flyby, we can probably actually just do with Thor-able parts. Although that AJ-1037 is so unreliable. Don't really want to be messing around with it. This we need avionics for. This we need... Yeah, this is also going to be super tough. Have to precisely end our kick. Like, technically we could do this with the rocket we flew, although it's so unreliable that I don't really want to be in the business of flying it ever again. Okay. So we'll get our J-57. And I'll shift this around. Even though we don't even need material science for the solids, now that we've achieved orbit, the solids don't actually help us until we have the rest of the kit. We also need this. We don't need it immediately, but we'll need it to do solar power. Oh, and we need lunar range comms also. So we'll just be grinding out a bunch of these. Oh yeah, also we need to be saving up money because we will need new astronauts. Because retirement is coming up pretty fast. 1958. A couple of them are retiring late in 58. Dale made it all the way to 1959. So I don't have to worry about this for another 2 years. Okie doke. So, we'll load the clean version of this. J57. Right. Okay, let's There we go. What did that do to our center of mass? Oh, that's better than I feared. Oh, that's worse. Okay. So how much area does this need? This needs 0.27 square meters. This provides 0.3. I'll do this. Stupidly ugly. Now it just looks like an X-32. Yeah, it's kind of funny. fact that the landing gear retracts through the intake is not great, but apart from that, it's okay. I mean, like, the X32 is the happy guppy. So. I want to see what this did to my area ruling, though. Okay, Farr, what do you think? So that's what we were going to do. We were going to move these tailplanes up because we'll not be flying at high alpha. And what Farr really wants us to do is something like this. But I can't bear to do it. Wait, how is that making it worse? So, things I could do to this. I could give it a really long shock spike. That always helps. What do I have tooled? I mean, I guess it's probably fine. Because this is already cheaper than the one with the. Yeah. So I don't need to tool it. Okay, let's see if this. Actually makes it worse. That's very interesting. I did not expect that. I really did not expect it to make things worse. Okay, it just needs to be stupidly long. Apparently, that's the important part. Paint it black. Okay. And we'll put some lead ballast in it. Okay, that just barely makes it statically stable. I'll take it. And I don't think I really want to make any other changes. I guess the one other thing I could do is I could add a little baby drag body there, or anti-shock body, I guess is what they're called. Okay. That is helping less than I thought it would. Yeah, that's not actually helping. So I'm just not going to bother. This is still pretty low. I mean, it's not super low, but it should be doable. All right, let's. Now, give ourselves kerosene. And I'll put an hour in there because we will very definitely be, I guess 45 minutes should be enough for anybody. Bye-bye, parachute. We've literally never used it. Yeah, this thing did end up coming out looking like an A7. Just that it's got a... I mean... From here, it looks like a fish bed. From here, it looks like an A7. Okay. Let's put the gear down again. I'm gonna sim it just to see what it's like. want to see how fast we can go with the J-57. My hope is we can break Mach 2 without going over the thermal limits of a J-57. See if I will be safe to take off from the runway, or if I have to air launch. Full wet. Rotate. And off we go. That was painless. It looks so ridiculous. It looks even more like a fish than usual. All right, we can lay off the burner. Let's just go for altitude. So this thing definitely has a ludicrous quantity of thrust. I miss my waterfall plumes. Let's get up to 20 kilometers. So if you... So zipping up my game data is not a thing that I or anybody else should be doing. It breaks the licenses on some mods. But if you click on the link in the about in the channel description, or if you're watching this on YouTube, just in the description of the video, there's a link to the repository that has the mod list, and it has a CCAN mod pack that you can literally just pop into CCAN and it will install everything. Alright, let's go for a sprint. Okay, let's get out of the transonics. Okay, that should be fine. Alright, we're getting close to Mach 2. Let's try higher. Hey Max, thanks for coming by. I'm actually about to throw in the towel, I'm sorry to say, it being when I am. But I did my first scientific satellite. I've unlocked J-57 for grinding supersonic flight. Looks like I'm in pretty good shape. And we built a happy guppy. So this is basically I flew the last rocket flight from this plane that I will ever fly, because it went to 75 kilometers, and there's really, like, I can't risk going to 80 because it'll probably kill the pilot. So instead, this is getting converted to a jet. And at this speed, the thrust-specific fuel consumption is very bad. Yeah, this has been a highly successful aircraft. It did basically... Oh, engine's getting a little hot. Oh no, the tail is getting hot. Right. I forgot, because these aren't supersonic wings. I forgot about that part. So, sprinting along at over Mach 2. What is this going to top out at? So I need to rebuild this with supersonic wings. That is a good reminder. Interesting, the cockpit is also overheating. I did not expect that. I guess we're too low to be running at Mach 2 for great lengths. Yeah, still haven't actually hit the... The max on us. So we're well past Mach 2. We're at Mach 2.3. The way I plan to upgrade them is I plan to open the craft file in Notepad and find and replace, and then open the craft and save, and then open the craft file again in KSB, and they'll be changed. That is how I plan to change them. It looks like the decals are also hitting a thermal limit. Maybe? Hard to say. Like, I don't know what gauge that is for. That gauge right there. Oh, it's the engine, I think. Yeah, because the engine is getting close to its thermal limit. Yeah, I don't think the decals are actually at their limit. All right. Looks like we top out at Mach 2.5. Or, you know, atmospheric autopilot could just decide to pull up too hard and rip the wings off. Oh, that was hilarious. So the engine reached its thermal. Once the wings were off, the engine quickly reached the thermal limits. That was hilarious. Oh, that's interesting. Atmospheric autopilot is holding us to our vertical speed by dint of body lift. So let's bail out. I want to check that this works okay. We. So we slowed down real fast. We hit terminal velocity really fast. Yes, super. Yes, supersonic bailout was not a great idea, but I wanted to see if it would pop the Kerbal or not. And I wanted to see what my terminal velocity would actually be. So we're down to 200 miles an hour. So we'll deploy the parachute. Our angular drag is pretty low, though. And so that slowed us right down. That chute deploys so fast. I need to see about if there's a way to edit it so it doesn't deploy quite that fast. So down we come. Yeah, supersonic bailout is not fun. Should not be tried in practice. Here we come. Feet. Feet. There we go. And sploosh. Okay. So that worked. Verified that you can in fact bail out. and that the J3 is a pretty good plane. Except for, you know, the thermal limits of stuff. Yeah, so the decals are not hitting their thermal limits. They're rated for being on the outside of a heat shield. It was just all the wing. It was the wings. All of it was the wings. Well, other than the engine and the cockpit, but yeah. So this is the J3. And then... Dash Supersonic is what it's called. Alright. So let me... Reload it. How does it contain experimental parts? Oh, I didn't buy that. That's why. Yeah, that's what's going on. I bought the regular wing, but I didn't. Wait. What the heck else was experimental? Oh, that's what's experimental. The intake. Okay. There we go. So we'll edit that, and then we'll fly. Oh, it's only going to take 20 hours to edit it. So we'll do that, because... and who had just flown? Dale had just flown, so we'll set up Paul. And we'll just wait until Paul's trained. We don't even necessarily need to air launch it. We can save the 245 funds. So on that happy note, thanks everybody for watching, and I'll catch y'all later. Night.